The basic recipe for soap has been unchanged for over 4,000 years. Add a strong base to a fatty acid and allow saponification to yield a substance perfect for cleaning. But just what is it that makes soap the perfect cleaning agent? If you've seen my previous videos about stickiness or using salt to melt ice, then you've already seen the practical utility of intermolecular forces. Soap is another example. Different atoms in a molecule have differing greediness for electrons. Oxygen is very greedy and in water steals the electron density away from the two hydrogens. This results in a polar molecule, with one end being more positive and the other more negative. Neighboring water molecules can then interact, positive to negative, much like two bar magnets. Molecules like hydrocarbons are considered nonpolar or fattier because they share their electrons relatively equally, meaning their interactions with their neighbors are far weaker. One of the classic phrases in introductory chemistry is like dissolves like. Try to mix oil and vinegar and the two will just separate out. That's because it's favorable for polar substances to hang out with other polar substances, while nonpolar ones hang out elsewhere. Soap doesn't deal in absolutes and is able to bring balance to these two forces. The molecules are typically pretty long, with one end being polar and the other being nonpolar. If you're scrubbing a greasy plate, anything polar will dissolve straight into the water, while anything nonpolar gets shielded by spheres of soap molecules called a micelle. Nonpolar ends of the soap trap and make friends with the fatty bits, while the polar ends interact with the water, allowing any grease to be washed away. When it comes to cleaning your hands, soap plays a very similar role. Millions of bacteria adhere to your skin, and their outer membranes are actually very soap-like, with nonpolar fatty bits in the middle and polar parts on the outside. Rubbing your hands together releases the bacteria's grip on your skin, while the soap helps them make friends with water and wash them away. In some conditions, soap can even break apart the bacterial cell membranes and kill them off. Not bad for a substance as old as the ancient Babylonians. If there are any topics you'd like me to cover, please feel free to comment below. And if you like this video, how about giving it a like or sharing it with your friends?